Lupe and Ryan Garcia.
It's a dream team, bro.
It is a dream team. That's true.
It's a 1-2 punch, like check.
Yeah, it is. You know what? I think it's important. I was saying Lupe and Ryan that it's important to always find good people, and you learn a lot from the professional, you know. And I believe that Ryan has an amazing future in boxing. He has an amazing heart. I know him since, man, I don't know, maybe 3 years ago. And I went to his one of the gyms where he used to work out, and I saw how he treated the people, and I love that. When you treat the people with respect, and you got the time to take a picture with your fans, to me, it means a lot. So that's what he does.
You know, very few people in boxing have as many fans as Ryan, and he hasn't even scraped the surface yet.
I know, I haven't even started.
Well, right now, he was just with a t-shirt, and somebody brought him a jacket, because he was cold.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, yes. Showing love out here.
That's cool. Piolin, I see you have a belt. Who are you going to fight?
Me.
Against him?
No, you want to fight.
Guess who's going to win?
Go vote in the comments.
Right now, Ryan has the fastest hands in boxing.
He's so fast, man.
And he has power. It's not just speed.
Power comes.
Listen, the speed is so, he's so fast that people on social media were saying, oh, he didn't hit him. You had to get it in slow motion to see that hit.
or so they always think you speed up the video.
I called it the ghost punch my last fight.
But
like,
hey,
like Muhammad Ali's phantom punch. So made up a name.
You know, Ryan's making people believers one at a time. Yeah. They didn't think he was going to fight Duno. He knocked them out. Always surprising people.
Always, man. I'm looking to make a statement in 2020. I wanted to shock the world. So look for me to have a huge fight in December or sometime in late year. You know, I'm just looking to make a statement.
Linares and him may happen in December. Maybe. I don't know. But I like the fight. I think you knock him out.
I wouldn't even fight him in December. I'll fight him earlier. To me, that's not the big fight.
Really?
No, it's not the big fight. To me, a big fight is even bigger than that. I'm not, you know, Linares is just a step to the big fight. You know, I got to pass him and I get to a bigger fight. And I'm sure, you know, he don't want to let me just, you know, get to that big fight. He wants to beat me in Linares. But for me, big fight is after Linares.
One of the champions?
Of course. So one of the huge names in boxing. That's what I'm looking for. And I want to do it this year.
Ryan said he wants to be Pacquiao's last fight.
Oh man, that would be amazing, man.
I was talking to Lupe about that.
That would be amazing.
That's a discussion we've already had, and I think it'll be amazing, you know?
It would be, because look, Pacquiao fought De La Hoya, and it was De La Hoya's last fight, and he passed the torch, so now...
Now you got Manny me. Can...
Get ready for Pacquiao, so...
So, really quick, tell people a story. You walked, was it Chick-fil-A?
Yeah, Chick-fil-A.
What happened?
I went to... get food, you know, and they see me in the back car, and you know, they go crazy. They're like, oh, it's Ryan, like, what is crazy? Like, they all stopped, took pictures of me, and you know, I didn't get my food till 20 minutes later.
but it has
I pretty much can't go anywhere now. Like, I go to like any normal place, like, I get stopped like crazy. It's like, it's cool because, like, I've seen it evolve, you know, when I first started seeing fans come up to me, like, it was here and there, but now it's like everywhere. So.
Most boxers get recognized at boxing events, but they don't get recognized in the street or the very few, like Mayweather, Pacquiao, Canelo, and now you're among them.
Man, it's crazy, man. And I'm only 21, so just imagine when I'm like 26, 27, like, it's gonna be crazy.
By the way, it sounds like Jake Paul is gonna fight.
Yeah, January 30. We were just talking.
Yeah, Miami.
He wants to come train with us. Like, we did a little test, but he was telling me, like, hey, bro, all right, like, I got a fight link signed. You got a fight signed. Let's get together, because Instagram and Snapchat, they want us to do, like, a series for them. So we might do something for them.
Well, hopefully you can help him, because he has potential.
Yeah, he does. I mean, it's fun. To me, it's all fun. I mean, you know, with me, it ain't no fun and games. But for him, I think, you know, it's a good experience. And, like, if he can make good money, why not?
Last thing. So what does it mean for you and for Lupe to be here today and give back? Because you could just, honestly, you could send a check. You don't have to physically be out here in the cold.
Nah, but I like to, like, hear the people, feel the people, and just, like, give them my advice, show love in that way, too. Because, you know, you want to speak to their mind to give them, you know, ways to improve and ways to, you know, keep hope and determination to do something great in life.
Yeah, there's a lot of families that they go through struggles and they go through a lot. You know, some of the family that was talking to right now was the dad is sick and he's not able to work, and some of the children, they're not expecting anything this Christmas, and being here, man, it's amazing. I think it's important to share your blessings to all the people who's in need.
And it shows Brian's still very humble to do this because honestly, he's a star.
You know, I think it's really important when you get people like Ryan, Piolin, Brandon Rios, because a lot of these people that are here, a lot of these young kids, these are things they'll remember for the rest of their life. You know, you bring a smile to them, they get a toy, and they'll always remember that. So, you know, it's good to spend your time. It's easier to write a check, but it's more meaningful when you're here.
That's true.